If you got a motherfucking check in your pocket, DJ Iceberg, pull it out right now and contribute. Yeah, I'm standing at a table full of trappers. I pop a perk and take off like a nest. My niggas down rap, but look like rappers. Cause when we get that word, we flip it back with love.
You ain't got no paper, you ain't poppin'. You ain't got no paper, you ain't poppin'. You ain't poppin'. You ain't got no paper, you ain't poppin'. You ain't poppin'. You don't got no paper, you ain't poppin'.
I met a bitch from uptown, I'm like, whoa. Patron shots a couple of rounds, she like, whoa. My niggas ain't fucking around, they gon' go. Think I'ma spend a check on that pussy, I'm like, no. I put your bitch in a phantom, that shit big as a planet. Got some bitches in Paris that speaking French like Montana. Got a bitch in the projects, she be holding a hammer. Landed in California, about to go to Atlanta. That be my bitch from Miami, she won't be on the team. I'm moonwalking that pussy, she thinking she Billie Jean. I got a tech sitting on the step, and that's on the set. Here I go, ring a nigga neck, all about a check.
Deepcover TV, it's your host Sierra. I'm here with EastsideIvo, Detroit's finest. How you doing?
How you doing? It's Ivo Squeeze, by the way. I mean, I changed my identity here and there. Mr. Squeeze himself.
Well, what's the squeeze
for? We don't have a meaning into it, but I just think it got a ring to it. That's all.
Okay, dude.
I might become a rapper and use that as my little alias.
It works. What brings you out to Baltimore tonight? Be there, cool and
Sunday comedy.
Cool Sundays.
Yeah.
What are you out tonight?
I'm on a tour that I put together myself because I'm not signed to nobody. I'm a boss comedian. That's what I label myself as. Baltimore, Philly. I went to Philly yesterday. And I'm going to DMV tomorrow area, have fight DC. And then I'm going to stop in Jersey.
Okay. Alright. So I must ask you, what?
Right, so loud.
I'm loud?
They are.
Oh, they are loud. Right.
Quiet on the set.
Quiet on the set, homies.
Hold on.
Hey, listen, you know people don't listen all the time. So what would you say made, when did you find out that you were funny?
I was born funny. This is
how you know,
I was funny. I always been funny. You know what I mean? I just had to put it behind on camera. At first, I just wanted a little bit of money and some females.
Okay, cool.
I didn't think it was gonna go this far. You feel me? All
right.
But I made it a career. You know what I mean? Ratchet females. Let me get this straight. I don't wear female clothing. You know what I mean? I don't twerk. I don't act like I, you know what I mean? I'm having sex with the, I play the boy role, the girl role, then grandma role, granddaddy role, all roles. You know what I mean? I'm a role player.
Okay. Speaking of female clothing, though,
you do wear wigs.
Yeah.
For your skits, your sketch, and all that stuff, how would you say that impacts your audience, especially your male audience?
I don't wear female clothing, though. It's just the ratchet wig. It don't even be a lace wig. It'd be a fucked up ass wig, you know what I mean? But it's just impersonating ratchet females. Because I know women. I love women. You feel me? I love women. I got them down to the T. But from a male point of view, it really don't matter. Because females really is the ones who really spend their money. So if you ask your guy, I want to go see EastsideIvo, he going to take you. So now I got you and him.
Right.
You feel me?
Because
you're going to show him like, babe, look at this funny video. So now I got your attention. And wherever the female's at, niggas don't follow. Message.
What is the relationship between you, Bodega?
I used to be a rapper. Seriously, that's why I live like when I sound a little flashy and stuff. But I used to rap when I was 12, 13, 11 years old. And she was like associated with the rap group where I'm in. And we share a family member. Like her godson, which is her best friend's son, is my cousin. That's my uncle's son, Tristan. So, and that's my man. So I knew her since she was 16 years old. She always loved music, and she knew she was going to make it regardless of what everybody else thought.
You said you're on tour. What's new that you got coming out? What's the next city that you're hitting?
The DMV.
DMV?
DC, Virginia, all that kind of area, I'm going to be there tomorrow. Yeah?
Tomorrow he there. Okay, EastsideIvo. It's your host,
Mr.
Sierra.
Squeeze.
Just like that. EastsideIvo. Ivo. Mr. Squeeze.
Ivo Squeeze.
Ivo Squeeze. I'm sorry. Ivo Squeeze. It's your host, Sierra. It's Deepcover TV.
EastsideIvo.
What's the deal, world? It's your boy EastsideIvo, aka Ivo Squeeze, BKA Mr. Squeeze. You are rocking with Deepcover TV. Eastside. Oh, that's first take shotty right there. That's first take. If I had the energy I had before the show started, I probably would have been up there on some silly shit. But I'm over there hungry, getting blessed. Oh, y'all still recording me? These are my bitch snatchers. Attack. Watch.